whenever port is configured as output, the port register, port A register, let us be specific like port A to avoid confusion between the word port and the register port. Port A register, whenever we configure port as a output port, port A register is used to write the data onto the port. Now the second thing is, whenever we have configured the port as an input port, that time the function of port register changes. During that time, port register is used to configure the type of the input port. And those two types are pull-up and try-stated. Let us see those functions one by one. Suppose you have configured a particular port as output port. So you want to write the data onto that port. Let us take a specific example. You are configuring port B as output port and writing data, some data onto it. How you will do it? First, we are configuring port B as output. And now, we have to use a port register to write the data onto port B. Port B equal to some data, say 100. So this will write this value onto the port B pins. That is for writing the data onto the port. If you want to write some variable, you can write like this. However, you have to make sure that this variable is an 8-bit variable. If it is a 16-bit variable and you are trying to write port B equal to X, then only lower 8 bits will be assigned to the port B. The higher 8 bits will be ignored. Then the second function of the port register is while is configuring the type of input, the tri-stated or pull-up input. Input configuration. Whenever a port is configured as an input port, at that time, if a bit in port register is set to 0, then that particular pin becomes the tri-stated input pin. What is this tri-stated means? The tri-stated means a pin goes into the state of high impedance, wherein it is directly connected to the internal buffer, so it floats. It is having no fixed logical value. It can change its logical value quickly depending on the surrounding static charges or whatever voltage that has been given to the pin. This mode should not be used unless explicitly required. As far as a robotics application is concerned, we will have to use this mode only when we are using an ADC, analog to digital converter, on port A. While using ADC on port A, you have to make port A as tri-stated input. Now the second thing, whenever a bit in the port register is returned to 1 and port is configured as input, then it becomes pull-up. What is meant by pull-up? A pull-up is the fixed register that is connected to a particular pin internally, and that register is tied to the VCC, so that whenever nothing is connected to the microcontroller pin, the pin has a fixed logical value of, the pin has fixed voltage level of 5 volts, and that reads the logical value. If you are making a pin as tri-stated and using it in your program for controlling the program flow, then even slight external disturbances can change the logical state of the pin and your program may get haywire. So that's why it is recommended that whenever you are using port as a digital input, it is better to make it always pull up unless you are using analog to digital converter or it is specifically required to be a tri-stator one. Let us see what is basically a pull up. A pull up resistor is used to ensure that the tri-stated input always reads high when it is not driven by any external entity. Pull up is very important whenever you are using tri-stated input buffer. Tri-state input pin offers very high impedance and thus can read as logic 1 or logic 0 because of minute static charges on nearby objects. This causes pin state to change very rapidly and it may affect your program execution. So it is always recommended that you use the pull-up resistor. In case of 8051, some ports are not having pull-up resistor, so you have to connect external pull-up. But since all ports on AVR are having internal pull-ups, you can enable them whenever you are using those ports for input purpose. As the diagram explains, whenever you configure port as an input port and set a bit in the DDR to whenever you configure port as input port and set bit in the port register to 1, it becomes a pull-up. At this time, this MOSFET inside the AVR gets activated and connects internal pull-up register to the VCC and fixing the pin logic state to the logic 1. Now, in order to clear the concept, we'll see some examples how to configure the ports. Now, let us make port A as an input with pull-ups enabled and read data from port A. What we want to do? We want to make the port A as input. So first step is configuring the DDR register. DDR A is equal to 0xFF. This will make port A as an input. Configuring DDR register. DDR A is equal to 0. This will make port A as input port. Then the second step is we want to make port A with pull-ups enabled. So you have to configure port A register to value FF. So we are making port A as input with pull-ups enabled. And then read the data into variable X by writing X is equal to pin A. And then read the data into variable Y by writing Y is equal to pin A. Now second example. Make port B as tri-stated input. Simple. Again, DDR B is equal to 0. So that will make entire port B as input and port B equal to 0. That will make port B as tri-stated input. Then we can start reading data from the port B. Let us see the third example. We want to make lower nibbles of port A as output and higher nibble as input with pull-ups enabled. What we have to do? We have to make lower nibble of port A as output. And higher nibble as input. So by writing 0F, we are making lower nibble as output and higher nibble as input. But that input should be with pull-ups. So we have to write 0xF0 into the port register. This will make this input nibble as pulled up. Getting DDR A is equal to 0F. That will make port A lower nibble as output and higher nibble as input. And writing port A is equal to F0 will make this input nibble as a pull up. Then we can read the data from this nibble. So now let us look at the summary and quickly revise what we have seen. We have seen that there are three registers associated with every port. They are DDR, port, and ping register. DDR stands for data direction register. This is used to control, to configure the input-output direction of the port. Then the second is the port register. Port register is having different functions depending on the whether you are using port as output port or as an input port. And the third register is the pin register, port in register. It is used to read the values. If you look at this table, you will quickly understand this relation. Whenever bit in the DDR is written as 0 and bit in the port is written to 0, then that pin is configured as tri-stated input. Now, pin X register is used to read the data from that port pin. Whenever you are configuring a bit in DDR register to 0 and bit in port register to 0, then pin is configured as tri-stated input and you can use pin register to read the data from the port pins. Now, keeping DDR as same, if you now change the bit in the port register to 1, then it becomes pull-up input. Again, pin register is used to read data from the port pins. Now, whenever you are configuring DDR as 1, then the port becomes the output port. Now, in this case, port register is used to write the data values onto the port pins. In this case, pin register is not used. If you use it, you will get the same value that you have written into the port register. So we have finished the basic introduction to the input output of the area. Now we'll see, we'll have a small exercise. Now we will see one example, a simple LED PC. The example is written in BinAPR. Let us see the explanation one by one. First line is hash defined F underscore CPU and 16 megabytes. This line will tell the compiler the operating frequency of the microcontroller, which in this case is 16 megabytes. After that, you have to include these three files, io.h, sfrdefs.h and delay.h, because these files contain the basic definitions for the input-output registers and delay functions that we are going to use. The program is started by writing int main. Inside the main, we have to write our entire program. The basic motivation of this program is simple LED blinking. So we are going to connect one LED to the port B, 7th bit, and blink it. So for that purpose, we have to make port B.7 as output pin. That configuration is done by these two statements. DDRB is equal to 0B, 1 and followed by 0s. Port B is equal to 0. This statement configures port B7's pin as output pin. And this statement drives data 0 to that particular 7th pin. Now to blink the LED continuously, we are writing infinite while loop. Inside the while loop, we are assigning port B is equal to port B or with underscore BV PV7. This macro, underscore BV macro, will give you 0x80 value. Inside the while one, in the first instruction, in the first statement, we are setting 7th bit, then we are waiting for 500 milliseconds. Again, we are resetting the bit and waiting for 500 milliseconds. This will cause LED connected on the port B.7 to blink continuously. As simple as that. You can compile this program, make a hex file and then burn it into the controller and see the demonstration. Now let us look at the second example. The include part is same. However, in this example, we are going to generate one pattern, a pattern of flashing LEDs. That pattern is defined into this character array called as pat. There are 7 different patterns in this array, as you can see. The one indicates that LED will be on. So we are configuring first port B as output port by writing DDRB equal to FF and then keeping all LEDs off. Now the second thing is we want to read the input. For this program we'll do, whenever you are pressing port C dot a button connected on PC3, only then LEDs will glow into the pattern. So we are setting PC3 as input with pull up enabled. This statement port C is equal to underscore BB PC3 will make PC3 as pull up input. Now inside the while loop, if bit is clear pin C comma PC3, this particular statement will check for the status of PC3. If the button is pressed, value of the PC3 will be 0, and so this statement will return evaluate to 1 and it will glow the pattern one by one onto the. If bit is clear, then this statement will evaluate to 1 and it will display the pattern array one by one onto the port B. We are providing a delay of 500 milliseconds to see the output. Thank you for listening to the first tutorial. Now in the second tutorial, we will see the timer, how to use and configure the timer.